Good day, fellow investors. Today I want to explain who I am, what do I do, and then how do I do it, and why do I think that would add a lot of value to you. I didn't do something like this since last May, when we had about 8,000 subscribers on YouTube. Now we are past 22,000, so there is about 14,000 people that really don't know who I am or what to do, so it's really time to do so. So before I focus on what's my really added value on investing and how you can get it in a complete package, not just on YouTube, let me talk a little bit about myself, who I am, what's my background, what's my education, and what's my investing style. That will give you a good perspective on what I do on my stock market platform, on YouTube, on my book, and then you will see how that fits and how can that really help you in your investing. That's the key. You just have to collect the data to make your financial decisions better from a risk-reward perspective to get to your financial goals. That's the key. If I can help you with that just a little bit, then I did a great job. So first, I'm a father and a husband, and that's my focus. And whatever I do, I try to inspire my family. So be the best you can be and let others be the best you can be. That's my motto. On the investing field, I've been investing for about 16 years now. The first stocks I bought were when I was 19, so 16 years. I'm getting older, but in 2002, and I did really, really well because I used to buy things that others didn't want to buy, but later they were crazy about. But at that point, they didn't want to buy it, but there was huge value in that. And I've been doing that over and over through the 16 years of my life. And that's what I'm sharing on my YouTube, my Facebook page, on my stock market platform. And hopefully it will work in the future like it has been working in the past. Just an example of the last value investment that I did that did well was Nevsun Resources. I started buying it in 2016 when it was cheap, and I thought that zinc and copper will do extremely well and that they were underpriced because the price was below cost production costs. That turned out was volatile, but it turned out really well. And I just keep doing that. I keep looking at unliked markets, waiting for them that they have the potential to rebound. And that's where I gain low risk, high return investments over a few years. I'm not a trader. I'm really a little bit longer term investor that likes to position myself into value investment bargains with high upside and limited downside from a long-term perspective. Here is the zinc example. When I invested it, it was really cheap. I believe it was like $0.7 per pound. Now it spiked above and now it's again down. So extremely volatile. And the stock market usually follows this volatility, stocks even more. And that's what you have to take advantage of and not be scared of. Similarly, in the past, I've been investing into frontier markets, extremely cheap stocks with very low price to book values and high dividends. And I'm always looking for those. I am a full-time market researcher, so the most of my week is spent on research. And then I share my research, what I can share publicly on YouTube. The rest is on my stock market research platform. So that's how I spend my days on the computer screen, looking at annual reports and sector analysis from companies. I do something myself, etc. So that's what I do. I find it very exciting going through numbers. Not everybody finds that, but that's me. If you find it exciting to go through numbers, then a PhD is something that you usually do, and that's what I did. I did the PhD where I analyzed the stock market risk. Could I find a formula that explains the investing risk from a perspective that risk is, okay, what can I lose? Not volatility, not standard deviation, which was tough to do in the academic world, but I managed to do it. And I managed to make a model that really proved, okay, this is something you can use. And it was, again, the academic way of saying value investing, margin of safety, quality, tangible assets, and earnings. Business earnings are the key for your investment returns. So that was my PhD. After the PhD, I did some work at Bloomberg, and I worked in the data research department. And the key there was that I saw how the data is transferred from the accounting, from the financial statements onto a terminal, a data terminal like Bloomberg. For example, one day I got a list of 30 stocks and the data about the stocks, and I went through that list because it was about a market I knew extremely well. Of the 30 stocks, I found 25 stocks with errors in data on the Bloomberg terminal. And I corrected that consequently, something not, something yes. But this told me, okay, if you're investing into the things that are not that covered, you really have to do your own analysis. And that's something that I hope to bring as an added value. From how to invest, how to analyze stocks, how to look into the accounting details, and then you see, okay, this is not what the market thinks of it. And that's why I think that hard work, value investing world work really leads to great investment returns. I have proven that for myself in the past, and I hope to prove that for you others here on the YouTube channel and Stock Market Research Platform. After Bloomberg, as I didn't like the environment of just checking data, researching data, I said I can do that myself. So I took a teaching job as an assistant professor in finance, where my major teaching lecture was international financial accounting. And when you teach international financial accounting for 3 years, then okay, then you really know accounting. So I knew some accounting, but this really gave me the fundamentals to do in-depth accounting analysis on businesses. And this is really helping me with understanding what's going on with the business, what are the convertible notes bringing in the future, what might happen, what is the tangible, the intangible assets, how to put that into a currency environment and things like that, that I transfer when I value stocks. So 3 years of accounting professorship at a university, the University of Applied Sciences in Amsterdam. I had a great time, but I preferred to teach online to people that really are interested in the matter. Let's be honest, 20, 22 year old students are not that interested in accounting, no matter how fun I want to make it. And then I said, okay, I'm going for myself. I started to do more and more market research, and I resigned from teaching and from the market research job I had for an investment firm in the US 5 months ago. So in May, I completely closed everything, and I'm a full-time independent stock market researcher sharing my research on YouTube and on my stock market research platform for the in-depth analysis and portfolio modeling strategies. On my investment strategy, it's really not that difficult. I'm a value investor and an asymmetric risk-reward investor. So value investing, I'm looking at stocks where in the long term, the potential for capital loss is minimal. So that would be a value investing stock with a margin of safety, and I'm looking there where there is blood on the streets. So that's one style of investing that has done extremely well over the past 100 years. Seth Klarman, Warren Buffett, Walter Schloss, and I made a video analysis on YouTube how value investing has beaten growth investing in 84 of the 90 years when backtested from 1926. Over 10-year investment periods. So that's the value investing. Plus, on the other hand, I like positive asymmetric risk reward. What does that mean? Positive asymmetric risk reward means, okay, if I invest in a stock, I can lose 100%, but if the upside is 500 of 1000%, then that is a positive risk reward for me. Oh, and if the chance of going to zero or exploding 10 times is 50-50, then if I have two stocks like that, one will go to zero, the other will go 10 times higher. So my return on investment is 500%. And those kind of investments are usually wrongly priced by the market. You have just to do a lot of work to find them. So I'm a value investor in combination to risk reward investor. When you can combine the two of those, then you have a great investment. If you find two of those every 3 years, you are a happy champ. But a lot of research is needed to do that. And if you don't have the time, you have me to do that for you. For example, in the last months, I've been going through China, I've been going through Brazil, I've been going through Argentina, I've been going to some miners, I've I will be going through gold miners for the portfolio macro hedge in case we have more quantitative easing. That's my next step. Then I'll be digging into Russian stocks to see, okay, there are high dividend yield, low price to book values. Is there some value? And how much portfolio exposure should we have that in light of what can happen? What's the maximum downturn drawdown? And what's the potential upside? And what do we get for holding that? And that's something I constantly do. I'll be looking at hedges, puts, buying out of the money puts somewhere in the beginning of the next year. And then I think in the next few months, 6 to 9 months, I will have a good portfolio that can withstand whatever can happen in the stock market and lead to a qualitative value investing return. That's my goal, and that's what I'm working on right now. And you see it's in bits on YouTube. But if you want to really check in depth what I do to see the whole process, then my stock market research platform is the only option.